Good morning, children. Today we start our class with a new method of multiplication. We studied so many properties: associative property, distributive property, commutativity property. Just like so many properties we studied, we use that properties here to make multiplication easier. Okay, let's see one example. Find the product using suitable properties. Here we don't multiply with our usual multiplication method, but we use here some properties. Okay, first question is 74 into minus 37 plus minus 37 into minus 64. Clearly, we can see one speciality is there. Then minus 37 is common. Here is two parts. 74 into minus 37 is the first part. And minus 37 into minus 64 is the second part. These two parts are divided with an addition sign plus. Okay. Then first part 74 into minus 37, second part minus 37 into minus 64. We studied A into B plus C equal to A into B plus A into C. A into B plus A into C. This is A is common. Just like here, minus 37 is common. So we take minus 37 outside the bracket. Okay, minus 37 into, then from the first part, if we take minus 37, 74 is remaining there. In the second part, when we take minus 37 outside the bracket, minus 64 is remaining. So we can write like this, minus 37 into 74 plus minus 64. We put that in a special bracket. Okay, then minus 37 into. Next is 74 plus minus 64. This is addition of positive and negative number. Then we subtract the smaller number from the bigger number and put the sign of bigger number that we already studied. So we subtract 64 from 74, that we will get 10. Minus 37 into 10 is minus 370. 37 into 10 is 370. Then only one negative integer is there. So the answer should be negative. This is the new method of multiplication. Here we used distributive property. We distribute minus 37 to both the parts. Okay. Then second question, B question. Minus 41 into 102. Here also we can use one property. Listen, minus 41 into 102. 102 can be written as 100 plus 2. 100 plus 2. We use like this because we can use one property here. That is the reason. Minus 41 into 100 plus 2. Then A into B plus C. Equal to A into B plus A into C. So we write minus 41 into 100 plus minus 41 into 2. This minus 41 is common for 100 and 2. We distribute minus 41 to 100 and 2. So we can write minus 41 into 100 plus minus 41 into 2. Minus 41 into 100 is minus 4100 plus minus 41 into 2 is 41 into 2 is 84. One negative number, so minus 82. Minus 4100 plus minus 82. Both are negative numbers, so we add the numbers. Minus 4182. Now we can find very easily. Next C question. 625 into minus 35 plus 625 into minus 65. Okay, here also which is common. 625 is common. So we write 625 outside the bracket. 625 into, then the first part remaining number is minus 35. In the second part remaining number is minus 65. So we write like this, minus 35 plus minus 65. Okay, now we can write it as 625 into, then within the bracket minus 35 plus minus 65. Both are negative numbers and addition is there. So we add the numbers and put the negative sign. That is 35 plus 65 is 100. Both are negative. So answer is negative. 625 into minus 100. That is minus 62,500. Okay, next question. 7 into 50 minus 2. Very simple. Here not addition but subtraction. We distribute 7 to 50 and 2. Write this. 70 into 50 minus, not plus, minus, because here 50 minus 2. So we write here also minus 7 into 2. 7 into 50 is 350. Very simple. Minus 7 into 2 is 14. When we subtract 14 from 350, answer is 336. Next E question. Minus 17 into minus 29. Here is one speciality, because the first number write itself, we can change the second number, minus 29. We can write minus 29 can be written as minus 30 plus 1. Minus 30 plus 1 is minus 29. So instead of minus 29, we can use minus 30 plus 1, because we should use any property here. We should use one of the property that we studied. So it is better to use distributive property. Minus 17 into minus 29 equal to minus 17 into, instead of minus 29, we can use minus 30 plus 1. Okay, put in a special bracket. Then we distribute minus 17 into minus 30 and 1. Minus 17 into minus 30 plus minus 17 into 1. Minus 17 into minus 30. We multiply 17 into 30, we will get 510. Both are negative numbers. That is 2 negative number. 2 is even number. So we should positive sign. Plus 17 into 1 is 17. But 1 negative number. So it is minus 17. The answer should be 493. Then this type of one more question. Like this type. Minus 57 into minus 19. Plus 57. Here in the first part 2 numbers, but in the second part 1 number. Here 57 is common. Then we write the first number as minus 57 into minus 19 plus. Here only the next second part, only 1 number. So we can write 57 as 57 into 1. No change in the product, because 57 into 1 is same as 57. Okay. We use distributive property. So we can write 57 into 1. Then minus 57 into minus 19. 2 negative numbers. 2 is an even number. So it should be positive. So we can write 57 into 19, because this should be positive. Reason is 2 negative numbers are there, plus 57 into 1. Now here 57 we write outside the bracket. 57 into, then balance is 19 in the second part plus 1. Okay, we know 19 plus 1. Here 57 first part, 57 second part. That is 57 outside the bracket, then inside the bracket 19 and 1. That is indicating by arrows. 57 into 19 plus 1 is 20. 57 into 20 is 1140. These are the methods of multiplication by using properties. Here we used distributive property. Next one, word problem. In a class test containing 50 questions, 4 marks are given for every correct answer and minus 2 marks are given for every incorrect answer. This is a questions like our VTSE examination. There will be negative marks. Here also negative mark. That is, if one answer is correct, we will get 4 marks. But if one answer is incorrect, 2 marks are decreasing. 2 marks are less. Minus 2 mark means 2 marks are decreasing. First question A. John attempts all questions, but only 9 of his answers are correct. What is his total score? That is the question. John attempts all questions, but only 9 are correct means others are incorrect. That is, 6 answers are incorrect. Because this is a word problem, so we write solution. Then what will be the first sentence? Marks given for one correct answer. That is 4. Then how many are correct? 9. So marks given for 9 correct answer equal to 4 into 9. 9 into 4, that is 36. So John got total 36 marks, but 6 answers are incorrect. So some marks are decreasing. Then marks given for 1 incorrect answers. How many marks? Minus 2 marks. How many are incorrect? But John's incorrect answers equal to 6. Therefore, marks given for John's incorrect answer equal to 6 into minus 2. Okay, 6 into minus 2 means minus 12. That means minus 12 marks are decreasing. From where? He got 36 marks. He got 36 marks for correct answer, but 12 marks are decreasing. So his total score equal to 36 minus 12. He got 36, but 12 marks are decreasing. So answer is, what is the answer? 24 is the answer. Another question, B question. The same statement is there. One of his friends get only 5 answers correct. What will be his score? Only 5 answers correct means total 15 questions are there. 5 answers correct means 10 answers are incorrect. Okay, we write the solution. 5 answers correct means 10 answers incorrect. Marks given for 1 correct answer equal to 4. So marks given for 5 correct answer, he got only 5 answers correct. 5 correct answers equal to 5 into 4. 5 into 4 is 20. Then how many marks for incorrect answer? Minus 2. But how many incorrect answers are there? 10. 10 incorrect answers equal to 10 into minus 2 equal to minus 20. Then his friend's score equal to minus 20 marks are decreasing, but he got only 20 marks. Out of these 20 marks, 20 marks are decreasing. That is minus 20. 20 minus 20, that is 0 marks. He got 0 marks. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.